Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Surah al-Baqarah, the surah of the cow, the special yellow cow. Why this longest surah in the Noble Quran named the Surah of the Cow? Well, let's discuss. We need to understand some background and some context. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is in Madinah al-Munawwara. There are three Jewish tribes in Madinah al-Munawwara: Banu Qaynuqa, Banu Nazir, and Banu Qurayza. They were people of the book, Ahl al-Kitab, people of the scripture. But the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was experiencing a lot of difficulties with them. And so Allah revealed Surah al-Baqarah here in Medina, reminding these Jewish tribes about the stories of Banu Israel with Musa alayhi salam, in the hope that these people will realize their errors and maybe learn from the mistakes of the people of the past. Thus, this longest surah in the Noble Quran was revealed. It has the greatest verse in the Quran, Ayatul Kursi, verse 255. It has the longest verse in the Noble Quran, Ayatul Dain, verse 282. And subhanAllah, it took over a decade for it to be revealed. It started in early Medina and it contains the last revelation to mankind. The last verse, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرُجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Fear the day when you are going to meet up with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verse 281. There are many, many stories in Surah Al-Baqarah. The story of Adam alayhi salam and his creation, Harut and Marut, story of Sulaiman alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail, building the Kaaba together, the story of David and Goliath, many, many stories. But why was this surah named after the story of Musa alayhi salam, his people, and the ordering of the slaughter of a cow? Why that story specifically? We will discuss. We find that majority of the ulama of the opinion that the names of the surahs were chosen by the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This was something via revelation that he told the Sahaba that this surah is called such and such. Whereas there are some ulama who state that no. Rather, majority of the surahs Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam informed the Sahaba about its name, and some of them, the Sahaba, they were the ones who used their own reasoning ijtihad and they chose certain names. But when it comes to Surah al-Baqarah, everyone agrees that it was called Surah al-Baqarah by none other than the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself, walhamdulillah. So what is so important about this story here? The story of Musa, his people, and the slaughter of a cow. What's the story with this story? We find that Musa alayhi salam, and kada al-Quran an yakun li Musa, and the Quran was almost about Musa alayhi salam. So many stories about him in the Noble Quran. Musa and Khidr, Musa and Fir'aun, Musa and his people, Musa saving his people, Musa as a youngster. So many times, 136 times his name is mentioned in the Noble Quran. Allah mentions this story in Surah Al-Baqarah only plus minus 8 verses. The story covers 8 verses, but the name of the surah was taken from this story. Allah states, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ, when Musa alayhi salam said to his people, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ, Allah orders you people, أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً, that you must slaughter a cow. قَالُوا, they responded, أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُزُوًا, are you making fun of us? Are you making a mockery of us? Are you playing games with us? قَالَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ, Musa alayhi salam said, I seek protection in Allah, I seek refuge in Allah, that I be from among somebody who is ignorant. What happened? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we find that Musa is speaking to the Banu Israel. Banu Israel, the children of Israel. Who was Israel? Israel was Yaqub alayhi salam. Yaqub is called Israel. And the children of Yaqub, from amongst them, Yusuf alayhi salam, Binyamin, and the other 10 brothers. So the 12 Asbat, the 12 tribes of the Banu Israel. And Musa alayhi salam, he is from the descendants of Yusuf alayhi salam. We find that Ibrahim, had a son by the name of Ismail. We are all familiar, mashallah. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes from that line. Well, Ibrahim had another son by the name of Ishaq. Ishaq had a son by the name of Yaqub. Yaqub, who is Israel. And Yaqub has a son by the name of Yusuf and Binyamin and 10 others. And all the Jewish tribes, they then descended from those 12 tribes of the Banu Israel. So then later on comes Musa from the descendants of Yusuf alayhi salam. So Musa says to his people, "Inna Allah ya'murukum an tadhbahu baqara." Allah has ordered you people, my people. Who's his people? The ones who came with him from Palestine. The ones who came with him from Palestine, and also now that he is in Egypt, the natives of Egypt, the people of Egypt. So they make up the people of Musa alayhi salam. Allah orders you people to slaughter a cow. Why slaughter a cow? What happened? What's the story? Well, we find in the Israeliyat, we find in the traditions of the Jews and the Christians, and our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that we can use these traditions. We should not 100% believe in them, nor should we completely deny them, but we can use them to fill the gaps, insha'Allah. That there was a rich man from the Banu Israel, and he had no kids. And he had a nephew who would eventually inherit from him. But this nephew was greedy. He was impatient. He wanted the wealth early. And so what did he do? He killed his uncle. Subhanallah. Look at the crime. Look at the sin of being greedy and the sin of being impatient. He killed his uncle. And what did he then do? He takes the dead body and he leaves it among some houses. And in the morning, when the body was discovered, he comes along and he screams and he shouts that you people have killed my uncle. You people have killed my uncle. And they were like, absolutely not. We have not done this and we don't know who did this. And the people broke up into like two groups and each one accusing the other. And this criminal, the perpetrator, the nephew, he obviously wants to falsely accuse someone else. Why? So that he can also benefit from the blood money. If he falsely accuses these people and they are found guilty in the court, then he will get the blood money from them and he will also eat from the inheritance. Allahu musta'an. And so the people are arguing, they're about to fight. And then from amongst them, some of them say, you know what? Let us go to Musa alayhi salam. We have amongst us a prophet. We have Musa alayhi salam who gets revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go to him. He will ask Allah who the killer is. He will find out this information for us. And thus they all agree and they head off to Musa alayhi salam. And so they come to Musa alayhi salam and they inform him of the whole story. And he gets the revelation that Allah orders you people to slaughter a cow. They are surprised. What's the connection between us wanting to know who the killer is and you ordering us and telling us to slaughter a cow? This sounds illogical. Are you making fun of us? Are you playing games, O Musa alayhi salam? Subhanallah, look at the attitude. They were basically accusing the Prophet of lying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered this. They believed in Musa. They believed he was a Nabi. And now they are saying, no, you are lying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said such. And Musa alayhi salam, he seeks refuge in Allah. And akuna min al-jahilin, he defended himself against this accusation that how can I lie with regards to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states. In fact, even our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Surah Al-Haqqa, verse number 44-47, that Allah mentions, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ, that even if the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to make up and fabricate statements from Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will finish him off. A Nabi cannot lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, now what was this order? Slaughter a cow. One might ask, why slaughter a cow? Why didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just give the answer? Couldn't Allah have done that? We know in the story of Jurayj, who was a pious, righteous man of the Banu Israel, and this woman comes along and she wants to commit adultery with him, and he refuses. She goes along, falls pregnant with a shepherd, and she has a kid, and then she says to the people, you people praise Jurayj, but he is not so good. Look at what he's done. He made me pregnant, and thus she had this kid. Later on, Jurayj comes there, People are accusing him of zina, and he asks the kid, while the kid's in the cradle, the kid's an infant, he says, who is your father? And the kid speaks and he says, my father is the shepherd. And thus Juraij was exonerated of that accusation. So couldn't Allah have done that? Just give the answer. No doubt Allah could have done that. But as we will see, there was great wisdom behind this longer method. With regards to the cow, we find the word Baqarah is mentioned in the Quran 9 times. 5 times in this surah, then once with regards to the pagan consecration of lawful animals in Surah An'am, verse 144, where these people were lying against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we find in the story of Yusuf alayhi salam and the dream of the king, 2 times it's mentioned, Baqarat, the cows. And so a total of 9 times in the Noble Quran. And now a question, why a cow? Why did Allah order them to slaughter a cow? Why not a bird? Why not a camel? It must be remembered that the Banu Israel, they previously sanctified the cow and they fell into the worshipping of the golden calf. The Ijil is mentioned 10 times in the Quran, the golden calf. And so maybe this was also a test to see if there remained any traces of this veneration in their hearts. Allah ordering them to slaughter a cow, previously they were worshipping the calf and the cow, etc. Are there any traces left of this veneration? This was a test for them, subhanAllah. Getting back to the story, and so to find out the killer, they needed to slaughter a cow. They could have went out and found any cow and slaughtered it. In fact, the kids, they know exactly what a cow is. But these people, they began asking unnecessary questions. Unnecessary questions like, what kind of cow? Allah mentions, قَالُ دُعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا فَارِضٌ وَلَا بِكْرٌ عَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ فَفْعَلُوا مَا تُؤْمَرُونَ. That they ask Musa alayhi salam, that you ask your Rabb. Look at that. You ask your Rabb, اُدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ, call upon your Rabb for us. Imagine, your Rabb. This is how they speak to Musa alayhi salam. They're not saying, our Rabb, ask Rabbana, ask our Rabb. But rather they say to Musa, you ask your Rabb. They're the ones who need the favor. They're the ones who want to know who the killer is. And look at their lack of adab, their lack of respect. اُدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ. Ask your Rabb to inform us, to make the matter clear for us, what type of cow. So, they're asking unnecessary questions. Allah made their lives difficult. إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا فَارِضٌ وَلَا بِكْرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you people to slaughter a cow. لَا فَارِضٌ. It's not very, very old. It's not one of those cows that has given birth many, many times and thus it's now very old. It's not one of those. وَلَا بِكْرٌ. Nor is it very, very young. عَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. It's between those two. فَفَعَلُوا مَا تُؤْمَرُونَ. Do what you've been ordered. Subhanallah. Do what you've been ordered. But do they do that? No, they don't do that. Compare the attitude of the followers of Musa alayhi salam to the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sami'na wa ata'na. We hear and we obey, they would say. Whereas the followers of Musa, sami'na wa asayna. We hear and we disobey. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would submit, the importance of submitting to the anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then they start to ask, this was the question about the age. And then they go further, this didn't satisfy them. They ask more questions. They ask about its color, subhanallah. قَالُ دُعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا لَوْنُهَا. Ask your Rabb, O Musa, to inform us about its color. I mean, what does the color have to do with anything? قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ صَفْرَاءٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them that it is a cow that is yellow. فَاقِعُ اللَّوْنُهَا. That it's very strong and rich in this yellow. تَسُرُّ النَّاظِرِينَ. But it's not a type of yellow that due to sickness or illness. Rather, it is healthy. This cow, it looks very, very nice. It's very healthy. تَسُرُّ النَّاظِرِينَ. It pleases the person who looks
looks at it.
So now they need to find a cow which is not very old, not very young. And then it's yellow, very strong and rich in its yellow. It's very healthy. It's not sick. They're making their lives difficult, subhanAllah. And when it comes to tasurru al-nadhirin, we find the ulama stating that when you give charity, don't give of the radi. Don't give of that which you wouldn't take yourself. Give that which is the best for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the unnecessary questions, the same happened to our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He ordered the people to perform Hajj. Somebody stood up and he says, Ya Rasulullah, every year, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah ordered you to make Hajj, make Hajj. He says, Ya Rasulullah, every year, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah ordered you to make Hajj, and so make your Hajj. Ya Rasulullah, every year, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, if I had to say every year, then it would become an obligation every year, and then you wouldn't be able to do it, subhanallah. Why are you asking these type of questions, making your own lives difficult? لا تسألوا عن أشياء إن تبدلكم تسؤكم. Don't ask about matters if they are informed to you, you're going to have a difficult life. We find Abdullah ibn Umar, somebody had come to him and he says that when I'm performing tawaf around the Kaaba, if I'm unable to touch the black stone, what can I do? Then Ibn Umar says to him, then you point something to it. Ara'aita, if I can't do that, then you indicate towards it, you point to it. Ara'aita, if I can't do that, don't you see, if I'm unable to do that, then what do I do? Abdullah ibn Umar asks him, where are you from? He says, I'm from Yemen. Abdullah ibn Umar says to him, the next time you come, leave your ara'aita in Yemen. Leave the ara'aita in Yemen and then you come and make the Hajj. Unnecessary questions. Allahu musta'an. So number one, they asked about age. Number two, they asked about color. Did they suffice with that? Absolutely not. Verse number 70. قَالُ دُعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ. That turn to your Rabb, O Musa. Ask your Rabb to inform us, make it clear for us. إِنَّ الْبَقَرَ تَشَابَهَ عَلَيْنَا. That this cow matter is confusing to us. وَإِنَّا إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ لَمُهْتَدُونَ. And by the permission of Allah, inshaAllah, we will be guided. SubhanAllah, the ulama state, had they not said inshaAllah, then they would have never ever found the actual cow. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatallah. This also shows us the importance of saying inshaAllah. We find in the noble Quran, Ismail alayhi salam, he said, ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. That inshaAllah you will find me to be somebody who has sabr at the time of the slaughter. Musa عليه السلام, when he was the student of Khidr, he also said, ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا. InshaAllah you will find me to be somebody who has patience. We find Shu'ib عليه السلام. Musa said to him, ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصالحين. I will work for you, and inshaAllah you will find me to be somebody who is righteous. The importance of saying inshaAllah in all matters. So Musa tells them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا ذَلُولٌ تُثِيرُ الْأَرْضَ وَلَا تَسْقِي الْحَرْثِ. That this cow here, لا ذلول, it's not used for plowing the fields. لا ذلول تثير الأرض ولا تسقي الحرث. People don't use it for plowing the fields, nor is it used for any of the irrigating of the fields. Dhalul means that which is used a lot. This cow here, it's not used a lot. مُسَلَّمَةٌ لَا شِيَةَ فِيهَا. مُسَلَّمَة, it's free of all blemishes and problems and عيبs. لَا شِيَةَ فِيهَا, there's no whiteness on it. There's no wasam, there's no sign on it. Sometimes people brand the animal with their names, etc. No branding on it at all. قَالُوا الْآنَ جِئْتَ بِالْحَقِّ فَذَبَحُوهَا وَمَا كَادُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. They said, O Musa, now the correct description has come. فَذَبَحُوهَا. And eventually they slaughtered it and they were almost not able to find it or buy it, as we will see. Where did they find the special cow? This beautiful cow, where did they find this prized cow? Well, the story goes from the Israeliyat that there was an old poor man and he had this calf as a prized possession. He's now old, he feels that his death is very soon. He makes dua to Allah that Allah keeps it safe for his family. Later on, his son grows up and then he eventually goes out looking for this cow now. Now it's big, it's a cow, and he finds it and he takes it back home. And this individual, this youngster here, was very dutiful to his mother. Alhamdulillah. His mother tells him to go and sell it in the marketplace, but don't ask for more than 8 dinars. Don't accept more than 8 dinars. And the story goes that there was an angel that came in the form of a man and comes to this boy and says that I offer you 10 dinars, 10 gold coins for this cow. The boy says, no, I can't. It's only 8. The man says, don't worry about the other 2. You keep it quiet. Don't inform your mother. The boy says, no, I can't do that. Then the man says to him that I offer you 12 golden dinars for this cow. You can keep the extra 4 for yourself. No need to inform your mother. Keep it quiet. The boy says, absolutely not. I cannot do that. And then the man says to him, look after the cow and do not sell it except for its weight in gold. Its weight in gold. And so later on, the Israelites, they come to this family because they realize that this boy here, this family, they have the special cow, this prized cow. And so the Israelites come and they want to buy it. And the boy refuses to sell it except for its weight in gold. And thus it was very, 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 very expensive. And the Israelites were almost unable to find enough gold to purchase it. And they just made it, walhamdulillah. And now the mother and the boy, they have more than they could have ever imagined of, subhanallah. All because this boy was dutiful to his mother. He didn't want to take the money from the man without informing his mother, subhanallah. Obedience to his parents. Allah mentions in verse 72, وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَادَّرَأْتُمْ فِيهَا وَاللَّهُ مُخْرِجٌ مَّا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. When you killed a man, when you killed a nafs, فَادَّرَأْتُمْ فِيهَا, and you cast blame on one another, وَاللَّهُ مُخْرِجٌ مَّا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ, and Allah will bring forth the truth with regards to what was hidden. فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا, and so it was said to them to strike this dead man with a part of it, with a part of the slaughtered cow. كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى, and thus Allah gives life to the dead. وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ, and He shows you His signs. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ, so that you might understand, so that you might use your aql. They were told to take a limb from this dead cow that they have now slaughtered and touch the dead man. And when they did so, the dead man miraculously came back to life. Imagine a dead limb from the dead cow touching this dead body, and life came out, subhanallah. Look at the modus operandi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man spoke and he mentioned who the killer was. He said that this is my nephew, and he is the one who killed me. And thus he was caught, and this criminal, the perpetrator, was eventually put to death. The victim spoke, and then he fell down dead once again. Subhanallah. So this is the story. This is why they were told to slaughter a cow. Don't jump the gun. When the Nabi told you from Allah, slaughter the cow, it was to eventually find out who the killer was. But you people were jumping the queue. You were jumping the gun. You wanted the answer right now. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, via the unfolding of these events, people were witness to a great miracle. And hopefully, they learned many, many lessons. As for the criminal we mentioned, he was put to death. What was his crime? He killed his own uncle, subhanallah. Why? Because he was greedy. He was impatient. And the crime of spilling unjust blood, it will haunt you. There's a story of this individual. He robbed somebody. After taking his wealth, he decides to kill this man. And the man says, please let me go. Why do you want to kill me? I mean, I'm not going to do anything. Take the money, take the wealth, go. He says, no, I don't want to leave behind any witnesses. And he's about to kill this innocent man. The man looks up and he sees 2 birds. And he says, you witness my innocent blood being spilt. And the story goes that the perpetrator, he sat to eat and there was chicken or a bird being served. Then he would always remember his crime. He was always haunted by that crime of spilling unjust blood. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, we saw that in this story, Allah gave life to that which was dead. We find in the Noble Quran, Ibrahim alayhi salam and the birds mentioned in Surah al-Baqarah, verse 260. We also find similar Isa alayhi salam and the clay bird in Surah Ali Imran, verse number 49. Then there's also the story of the man who died and then he was revived 100 years later. Also mentioned in Surah al-Baqarah, verse number 259. Why these stories? Why these events? Because you had many who denied the fact that we will be resurrected after our death, subhanallah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, it's also interesting to note that the story of Musa alayhi salam, the Israelites, the cow, this is one of those stories that you do not find in the Bible. But there is a similar story, there's some similarities between this story mentioned in the Noble Quran and one mentioned in Deuteronomy, verse number 21, 1 to 9. It's dealing with the law for human relationships. When you are in the land and your Lord, your God is giving you, someone might be found murdered in a field and you do not know who committed the crime. In such a case, your elders and judges must measure the distance from the site of the crime to the nearby towns. When the nearest town has been determined, that town's elders must select from the herd a young cow, important, a young cow that has never been trained or yoked to plow. Very similar to our Quranic story. They must lead it down to a valley that has not been plowed or planted and that a stream running and has a stream running through it. There in the valley, they must break the young cow's neck. Then the Levitical priests must step forward. And then it continues, the elders of the town must wash their hands over the young cow whose neck was broken and they must say, our hands did not shed this person's blood, nor did we see it happen. O Lord, forgive your people Israel whom you have redeemed. Do not charge your people with the guilt of murdering an innocent person. Then they will be absolved of the guilt of this person's blood, etc., etc. So not the exact same story, but there are some similarities between the two and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Some lessons from the story of the cow. That to the Jews of Medina al-Munawwara, do not be stubborn. Learn from the Banu Israel. Learn from the people of the past. Learn from their mistakes so that you do not implement those same mistakes. We learn about the evil of being greedy, of being impatient, and how it led to a murder. Murdering of a family member of your uncle, subhanallah. We learn that one should refrain from asking unnecessary questions. One should submit to the Nas. One should submit to the text of the Quran, the Sunnah. One should submit to the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find that we learn the lesson that one should be respectful to elders, to the Anbiya, to the Ulama. We saw that the Banu Israel were very disrespectful to Musa alayhi salam. They accused him of lying against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said to him, ask your Rabb, Allahu Musta'an. We learned the importance of saying, Insha'Allah. We also saw that the boy, he was dutiful to his mother. And because he was obedient to his mother, how much of barakah this brought to the family, walhamdulillah. Lastly, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we see the qudra, the power, the wisdom, the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manifested repeatedly in this entire story. So many times, one after the other, the wisdom, the hikmah, the qudra, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manifested, subhanallah. They just wanted an answer. Allah took them on this journey and they learned a million more lessons via this journey, walhamdulillah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us understanding. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from being greedy, protect us from being impatient, grant us sabr and grant us contentment. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.